down by your side. Just give them a little shake. Right hand comes to heart. Left hand comes up and extends. Turn and follow the gaze. Back to front. Moving hands to heart center. Mountain pose was one of the three poses. If you can do it every day. Mostly because it's grounding. Also, it has a stretch within it as well. So we're standing here. We're grounded, feeling strong. Hands are at heart center. We look at our position, our posture position. And when we're ready, extend your hands up. And then open your hands so they can stretch forward. In this position, let both hands come to the right. To center and to your left. Back to center. Let your fingers interlace each other. Turn your palms to the sky. Knuckles are facing towards your head. And take a turn to the right. Is it tree pose? Yes, it is tree pose. So if you need to step off the mat, find yourself a focal point. Get strong into that right leg. Turn the left leg out to the side. Find your favorite position just so it's not on your knee. When you're ready, bring your hands to heart center. And if you're feeling like you want to, those hands go up. Great job. Great. Let your hands come back down to heart center. And replace your foot. Good job. Give those hands a little shake. Getting strong into that left foot. Turning that right foot out to the side. Finding your favorite foot posture. Hands come to heart center. Finding your focus. During the week when you don't check in with me, remember cat-cow poses, mountain pose, and tree pose. It only takes a few minutes, and I promise that it will help you feel good. Okay, so I'm going to ask Fred to come up, and he's going to show us another pose for today.
The pose I'm going to demonstrate today is cow face arms and cow face legs. I don't know if we've done this before in one of our practices, but we're going to start out from the easy seated position with our legs crisscrossed. And basically what we're going to do here is we're going to cross one knee over the other knee. Crisscross pattern. This is cow face legs. You will feel it pull, probably in your calves, probably in your hips, maybe in your back, your lower back. Added to this, we're going to do cow face arms. So you're going to take your right hand up above your head, reach your left hand around behind your back, and if you can, try to touch your fingers together. Now this is going to be difficult because I find that my arms aren't long enough. Touch my fingers. But you will feel the stretch, you can use a strap for your arms. That may be helpful. Try to keep your back straight, remembering to breathe. Just hold for a couple seconds. The strap. Leave the strap, you could take the strap like this. Grab it with your hand behind the back and put your right hand down behind your back. So this is one good stretching position. And then once you've completed on one side, you flip over to the other side, and you kind of face it in the opposite direction. And one of these directions may be easier for you than the other. You may feel some cramping, like I feel cramping in my left foot right now in the arch. If you learn, that's probably common. So, and then you'll do the same thing to take your left arm up over your back. Again, if you want to use a strap, you could. It makes it easier. Connect those two arms. Stretch in your calves, probably your hamstrings a little bit, lower back. There you have it. Cow face arms, cow face legs.
Thank you, Fred. That's a, it's a hard pose. It doesn't look like that's a hard pose, but with my hips and my legs, I have trouble doing that pose, but Fred does it like it's nobody's business. But, you know, you do what you can, even if you just, you know, stretch it a little bit, little by little, it'll stretch and lengthen, and over time, you may be able to do it as easily as Fred does. So, back to the mat. Join me at the top of your mat. We'll do a little bit of a warrior flow, and then we'll do our pull down and Savasana. So join me here. And then let your hands come down by your side. Nice little breath in. Knee down. Let your knees bend and take a step back with your left foot so that your left foot is parallel with the back of your mat and you're leaning here to your right. And just let your arms float up to the warrior two arms here. Nice stretch looking out over that right finger, right middle finger. Let your right leg straighten, and once again, take a breath in, and out, and once again, bend into that right knee, let your right forearm come and rest on that right knee, left arm swings back like you're at the bowling alley, and then it comes forward and opens up, and let your chest open as well. Right leg is straight, hands to heart center for a breath in. Let that front knee bend again. Left hand comes back on your thigh or can bend at your back. Right arm extends up and overhead as we lean back for reverse warrior or peaceful. straighten your leg and let your hands come back down by your spine. And step back up to the top of your mat. Hands come to heart center. And breathing in. And out. Bend your knees. Send that right foot back so it's parallel with the back of the mat. There's a bend in the left knee. And arms come out to a T. Letting the gaze look out over the left middle finger. Check your position of your left arm. Make sure it's up as well. My warriors are looking good. And let your arms come down. Straighten your leg. Take a breath. Bend into that left knee again. The left forearm comes to rest on the knee. Pretend you're at the bowling alley. Right arm goes back and up over and opens as you look up towards those fingers. Come down, straighten that front knee again, take a breath in, and out. When you feel ready, bend that left knee one more time. Right arm comes back on the right thigh or in the middle of your back, and the left arm looks up as you lean back. Straighten that leg again. Arms come back down. And bend your knee and take it back to your mat. Hands come to heart center. Just for a minute. I'm going to take a step back a little bit. And we're going to come back down to our down dog. So from here, hands come to the mat. And we'll meet at down dog. And pedal up here. Let your left leg come over to your right just for a different kind of a stretch. And back over. Switch those arms, the leg over to the other side and let it have a nice stretch. Try a three-legged dog here where you lift the left leg up. And back down. Pedal up just a moment. And then we'll do the same with the right. And down. And once again, just a little more leg pedaling. And then let yourself come forward into a plank. And let your knees come to the mat. Toes come together and take a child's pose. Let your arms extend out in front of you. Breathing in deep. Take your right arm out to the right corner of your mat. And walk that left hand on top. And take a nice stretch toward the right corner of your mat. Then return to center. One nice deep breath here. And that left hand comes over to the left side of the mat. Right hand follows on top. We're going to return to a seated position from our child's pose. We're doing the cobbler, butterfly, moon and moth position. Soles of the feet come together. And with those legs, you can flutter them up and down. You can pull them closer to your groin area. Check in with your posture. Well, one thing's for sure today, we've got some stretches on. I think we stretched nearly everything. From here, let's put our feet out in front of us. We'll do a staff pose. A few more little stretches, and then we'll get ready for Savasana. So staff pose, feet are out in front of you. Legs are too. And back is nice and straight. Arms are on your knees at this point. So check in with your posture and your position. And let your arms reach up. Breathe back in. And as you exhale, bend from the waist. And head towards your toes. Maybe you touch them, maybe you don't. Maybe you grab a hold of your ankles and come a little closer. Maybe you don't, it's okay. And then just let your hands follow the contour of your shin. Back up to your knees. We're going to inhale again, arms go up. Let's do a nice stretch on one side. And then the other, and then both, and then bend at the waist towards those toes. Then release, and just let yourself come to the head. I'm going to ask you if you can just lie back. And feet are on the mat. The soles of your feet are on the mat. And let those legs go from side to side, either direction. We'll do a little bridge here before we close. Let your heels walk back to find your fingertips. And when you feel ready, take a breath in and lift your hips toward the ceiling or the sky. Option to bend the hands underneath the arch of the bridge here. Staying strong. And when you feel ready, unbend your hands and just let yourself come back down. And let your legs go from side to side. Cross your feet at the ankles and bring them towards you. Grab a hold of those toes and do your pretzel twist here from side to side. Taking some time to check in with yourself. When you feel ready, you can reverse. Cross over and grab that other toe. And once again. And you can prepare to dim the lights for this time of Savasana in your home or area where you are. Just to let yourself stretch out, legs out in front of you, arms overhead, and do a full body stretch here. And then coming back into your position for Savasana. Hands are open, palms are up, or if you're more comfortable with palms down on your belly, maybe you're more comfortable with your legs up. Whatever's comfortable for you, this is your time. Happy are the people whose God is the Lord. God is the true source of happiness, strength, hope, and wisdom. Those who are in His favor will always have these things. Also from Psalms 121, a devotion called Peace in the Chaos. And from Psalm 121, verse 2, our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Peace in the chaos. Something that sounded like firecrackers roused Joanne from sleep. Glass shattered, wishing she didn't live alone. She got up to see what was going on. The dark streets were empty and the house seemed to be okay. Then she saw the broken mirror. Investigators found a bullet only a half inch from the gas line. If it had struck the line, she probably would not have made it out alive. Later, they discovered it was a stray bullet from a nearby apartment. But now, Joanne was afraid to be at home. She prayed for peace. And once the glass was cleaned up, her heart calmed. Psalm 121 is a reminder for us to look to God in times of trouble. Here we see that we can have peace and calm because our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The God who created the universe helps and watches over us, even while we sleep. But He Himself never sleeps. He watches over us day and night, both now and forever. So no matter what kind of situations we find ourselves in, God sees, and He's waiting for us to turn to Him. When we do, our circumstances may not always change, but He's promised His peace in the midst of it all. A moment to bring yourself back in. Maybe you want to put your hand over your heart and see if your heart is feeling calm now. After this time of yoga, stretching and relaxation. And bringing back a little movement to yourself. Maybe moving your head a little from side to side. Working down to your shoulders, your fingers, knees, toes. And when you feel ready, turning to one side or the other into the position of a dreaming child. way, coming up into an easy seated position. Taking a breath in. As you exhale through your nose, your chin comes to chest. Noticing how different it feels from when we started to when we're closing our practice today. I noticed quite a bit myself of change and calm and peace and relaxed muscles. Next breath, let your hands come up. Palms move overhead. As you exhale, bring your hands to heart center and chin to chest. And together we pray. Lord God, thank you for your peace. Please continue to calm my heart in the areas of our lives that feel chaotic. Thank you for this peaceful time. Thank you for the Psalms as a reminder of your promises for us, knowing that we can have this hope, strength, and wisdom through you. And in your name we pray. Amen. Well, thank you all for joining us today. I look forward to starting up in September. Just a reminder that, weather permitting, every Wednesday evening in September, we will have outdoor yoga, standing practice, no mat required, followed by a walking type of meditation in nature, Wednesday from 5 to 6. So please join us if you're available. That's open to everyone. And I once again thank Fred for being part of this practice and supporting me, and Aaron, also thank you so much, and Glenn, thank you. And we'll see you next week for Faith and Yoga at St. Bartholomew's. Bye-bye, everybody.